Mixtures are combination of two or more substances or materials. There are three types of mixtures. Those are solutions, colloids, and suspensions. Here is a diagram of mixtures. Mixtures either form homogeneous mixtures or heterogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures have the same uniform appearance and composition throughout. The type of mixtures under homogeneous mixtures are solutions, while under the heterogeneous mixtures that have no uniform compositions and appearance are colloids and suspensions. Let us differentiate solutions, colloids, and suspensions from each other. Let us begin with their particle size. The particles of solutions are smaller than colloids and suspensions. Among these mixtures, solutions have the smallest particles. They can be represented by the small circles inside the box. Now, let us proceed to colloids. The particles of colloids are larger than solutions but smaller than suspensions. Their particles are intermediate between solutions and suspensions. The particles of suspensions are larger than solutions and colloids. They have the largest particles among these mixtures. It's just like a t-shirt. There are small, medium, and large sizes. Here in mixtures, the small size are solutions, the medium size are colloids, and the large size are suspensions. Now, let us move on to the appearance of these mixtures. Solutions appear clear or uniform, in which we cannot identify the components that we mix. For example, water with sugar. Colloids, on the other hand, appear cloudy. We cannot identify what we mix. For example, water and milk. Suspensions as well appear cloudy, but their components are recognizable. For example, water with oil. Here in this example, oil component settled on the top of water. Now, let us talk about their filterability, or their ability of being separated by filtering. Solutions cannot be separated by filtration. Their particles are smaller than the pores of the filter paper, and so they can pass through it. Same with colloids. Also, they cannot be separated by filtration. In suspensions, their components can be separated by filtration. For instance, oil can be separated from water by filtration. The particles of oil are larger than the pores of the filter paper, and so they cannot pass through it. They remain on the top of filter paper. Last property of these mixtures is Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect is the scattering of visible light by particles in a colloid or in a very fine suspension. It is only visible when there are large particles like dust or mist which can scatter light. In solutions, Tyndall effect cannot be seen since their particles are too small to scatter light. Here's an experiment about the Tyndall effect in solution. This is a solution of water and vinegar. As you can see, no path of light can be seen in solution. In colloids, Tyndall effect can be seen. This is a mixture of water and milk. Tyndall effect can be observed in colloids since their particles are large enough to scatter light. The light can penetrate this mixture. Tyndall effect in suspensions can be seen. This is a mixture of water and oil. This example of suspension exhibits Tyndall effect on part of the concentration of oil above the water. The examples of solutions which don't exhibit Tyndall effect are vinegar, alcohol, and soda. The examples of colloids in which Tyndall effect can be seen are paint, mists, and gelatin. The examples of suspensions which Tyndall effect can also be seen are flour in water, muddy water, and peanut butter. To sum up, the particles of solutions are the smallest. The particles of colloids are intermediate between solutions and suspensions. The particles of suspensions are the largest among these mixtures. Solutions appear uniform. Colloids and suspensions appear cloudy. Solutions and colloids cannot be separated by filtration, while suspension can be separated by filtration. Solutions don't exhibit Tyndall effect, while colloids and suspensions exhibit Tyndall effect.